here we are at the sewing machine trying to, we're going to stitch down the side of these blocks. I'm going to stitch with a 1/4 inch seam allowance. Now the reason that this is very important to stitch with the 1/4 inch seam allowance is so that all of your blocks will end up the same size, and that when you go to join your pieces together, they will, all of your seams will line up really, really nice. So I have the first one sewn together like that. And then I'm going to take the next block in the row and put that right sides together with this one. And then I'm going to stitch down this side here. So every time you get done sewing, you should always, as long as you position your fabric with the side of your foot. If you have a 1/4 inch foot, that's fantastic. It will help you be more accurate. But when you get done sewing and you look at your seam like this, you should be able to measure it with your ruler and identify that that is 1/4 inch. So you want to see your stitching line directly on the 1/4 inch line of your ruler. So if you sew with the same seam allowance for all of your rows, when you go to join them all together, they'll all be fantastically lining up and very, very nice. So this row is complete. So now we're going to move on to the next row. So I'm going to take these two and I'm going to put them right sides together and then line them up. If you want, you can pin these to make sure that they stay super straight and they're not going anywhere or not shifting during stitching. So I'm just going to stitch down this side here. And then once that's done, I'm going to put the next block right there. So I'm just going to grab it from my pile over here on the side, and I'm going to line that up, put it right sides together, make sure that my corners are nice and straight, and stitch down that side. Okay, so now that that row is done, I can do the next row. So I grab the next two blocks, I put them right side together, line up my squares really, really nicely, and then start sewing. Okay, so now I'm going to take my last block and put that right sides together with the last one here. Okay, now that we have all of our rows completed, so we have the bottom row, we have the middle row, and we have the top row. So all of these rows are now complete. So now I can sew the rows together. So I'm gonna sew the top row to the middle row, put both of them right sides together. And then this is where I'm going to nest my seams. So I'm going to put the seams right next to each other so that you can see how they make a nice little nest and they're meeting really nicely in the center. So, and then I can make sure that my corners are lined up really nicely. And so I'm going to nest these. This is a great spot to pin to. I tend not to pin a whole lot, but that is totally a personal preference. You can pin or you can not pin. So I'm just going to stitch 1/4 inch down the entire side here. And I'm going to pause at my seams to make sure that they are nicely lined up. If you pin ahead of time, I guess you don't have to pause. So there would be one advantage of that. So I'm just going to stitch all the way down. Okay, so now that I have that all done, I'm going to sew my last row on. So you can see how nicely the corners line up. I didn't lose a point, none of them are truncated. And also you can notice that you want your points to not be all the way at the edge, because when this is joined to another block, you want to be able to have that 1/4 inch seam allowance. So your points should stop 1/4 inch from the edge, so that when you sew 1/4 inch later, it's going to be perfectly on the edge. So we're going to sew our last row on. I'm going to lay it down flat, put my placement on there so that I can see how I want it to go. And then I'm gonna flip it right sides together. And then when I sew this one, I'm gonna sew it with this side that's already been sewn, not this one, so that I can see which direction my seams are going and that I'm not gonna twist them and sew one in the opposite direction. So if this one is pressed down, I'm gonna make sure that that stays down. And then I'll move this one to the other side, because that one hasn't been stitched down yet. So I'm going to sew with it this side up so that I can see which way those seams need to go so that they're not twisted at all, because that just adds extra bulk when you go to quilt later. So I'm going to stitch down the side here. Pause, make sure that I can get my seams nicely lined up. Okay, so I did not lock any seams in here, so I'm going to be very careful not to pull a whole lot on my seams. So I don't want to pull this way on my block because it will cause those stitches to come out. So this is it. This is how you make the friendship star. This should measure 7 inches. We have a very special template that we made just for this, and it is right here. So this is our Heartland Quilt Shop Rainbow Star, and this is the exact size all of your blocks should measure. So I'm gonna press my block real quick, and then press this, and I'll show you how to use it.